Okay, welcome to Farming Simulator 22. It's good, pretty exciting episode. We're getting a lot more of the ground cleared. We're gonna get some more of the auto drive markers set up. We're gonna get farming going. We're gonna get a lot of loads of dirt out of here. We're gonna start paving our area that we're gonna be building our house in the next episode. So hope you enjoy. Stick around till the end. We go through a lot of different things, cutting logs and sending trucks in and out and playing around with the course play and auto drive and terraforming. So hope you enjoy the episode.
See that a little later.
stays on, which is really nice because then I can fill it and it drives off on its own. And then it comes back after it's done selling. And the cycle continues, which is really cool, which would be great once we get enough money saved up from a couple. I've got 3 farm fields, which you'll see later in the episode too. I get the cultivator. Okay, let's see which plow or cultivator are we gonna go with. doesn't have to be too huge. The fields that we have are not very big. And we've got the course play, so we'll be able to set up a trail, which we'll go kind of through that a little bit later in the episode. You'll be able to see.
Start driving, which this way, and
I set the auto drive again, and it should have taken me towards home, but it took me towards the shop for some reason. So, you know, I hit drive, and it's set to home, and it starts driving me down this way. But in a moment, you will see that tractor with the cultivator on it is going to be heading towards me. You can see on the mini map, and there you can see right there. It's driving towards me, and I have it coming from the shop, going to the home. So I'm like, okay, well, I'm definitely going the wrong way. So what I do is I turn off the auto drive and head back manually. At least I want to get turned around, so I turned around and then I set home again. And you can see now I'm actually driving in the right direction. You can see on the mini, on the map there. Coming off of the bridge. And right in the tree, I didn't really have anything set for waypoints, so I had to mess with some stuff there. Now, let's take our tractor and we will do a little bit of work with our truck. Get some waypoints set for our auto drive. So we'll pull up our menu here. See the markers, I put them to where they're above the tractor. I kind of like how it's easier to see them. Get a couple set, and then you can start moving along. This will make it a lot nicer for when we go to do a lot of different kinds of chores on the field. You get it pulled up to the field here, and then you can set a waypoint, which you'll see in a second here. Get our waypoint. This is a field. Oh, I didn't pay attention. You'll be able to see it better right now as I'm editing this together. I'm not. It's a small picture up on the screen. In the editing software, so I couldn't really remember which field that was. Now we're setting another marker line going up to the second field. I've got three fields that are on my property, so I want to get this ready so once it's done cultivating the first field, then I can just set it to the next waypoint and it'll go set up for the next. Okay, waypoint set. Now let's head back out to the road and get the next little route moving towards the final field, which is nice. I get a lot of different waypoints. In the next episode, you will see I set waypoints like in garages and stuff like that, so we'll be able to, just like if we want to park our truck in the garage, we just set it to go park in the garage. That's all coming up in the next episode. Hotkey for that because the hotkey was one that kind of interacted with the the auto drive, so I had to mess around with that in the menu and stuff. Okay, we gotta go through and set all these different. We got field center, we got passes, like you can do on the outskirts. You do, I think I did three line pass, and then it's back and forth or up and down on the field. It auto set the width, so I'm happy about that. Like that it automatically did that. It generates a route, which once this menu comes down, you'll be able to see the route on the field itself that the tractor will follow with course play. And then when you go to hire somebody, I've noticed later in the game, once I've had things set, as you can see now, oh, it's field 19. I own 19, 20, and 21. What was I saying? Later in the game, when you set course play higher, you'll be hiring your employee and they'll follow that course. So once you have them set up on each field, all you have to do, because like I had saved and quit and then came back the next day to start this, and it was all set up still. So you just hit hire and it hired somebody to follow the course play. Hey, we're using our tractor here to start putting down pavement for our roads and stuff. Unfortunately, the truck's in the way there, so we'll just kind of go around it until I get it filled and it'll pull off on its own. Okay, well, I'll let you enjoy watching putting down some pavement and stuff, sending off some trucks, and I will talk to you in a little while. this, I was using my pickup truck to reroute my auto drive, because I had it a lot tighter than what I have the driveway set, which I fill all this in with pavement anyways later on, but I kind of wanted to follow that curvature of the pavement with my course play. As you can see off into the distance of the screen, I'm moving the little auto drive markers to kind of route it. As you can see, the truck, it stopped by the front loader because it's kind of blocking its route until I can get these points moved a little bit more. See the home marker there, and then we're gonna get all these moved over, and then we'll get a new marker set up, because that way I can set one truck going from the sell point to the that just indicated that something had stopped, and that tinging noise. But we'll get these set up and get a home two set up so that I can put one from sell point to home one, and then sell point to home two, and then when they come back, they'll be kind of offset instead of back to back. So if I want to fill one sooner than the other, they can both take off to the destination. Deleting some of these waypoints because it was too long for the amount of distance that I needed to set, so did that. There, now it ends to the home point for that one. And now what we do is we'll set up a new route. Set up another waypoint here, and then we'll take, and it pulls off of the main route, as you can see, and then we'll use this to go around on a separate trail that the truck that's going to waypoint 2, or home 2, will follow, so they can be parallel to each other just in case if they're both coming back at the same time. And we'll put it a little offset. We won't put it parallel with the home one because we want them offset so I can fill them at separate times. And get that marker set up. And we need to set and link that to trail that drives out. Bingo, there we go. Okay, let's get over back to our front loader. Back on again. different layers of dirt. I'm not sure why the roller isn't working. It's not, it, I can, I have it in the game, but it does not give me the terraform possibility with it. And see, it wasn't full. Tarps and away. better than it used to be. In FS19, a lot of times I would set up higher and I would have to come back to the tractor up in the trees or up the side of a hill or whatever. The Yukon map, the Yukon Valley map, is really nice. I like all the flat fields, and trees are pretty far away from the edges of the field, so you're not getting stuck all the time. And with course play, it makes it a lot nicer. So one last pass after this one, so we'll head off and do something else while we wait. Cut some trees here. We want to keep expanding outwards, but we need to get the trees cut and loaded. And we have a waypoint at the sawmill too, so we'll be able to descend a lumber truck to the sawmill. I've got it set as right and left mouse click at the same time to pull up my menu. It used to be delete, but it was interfering with something, or no, it was the right click was to activate the menu, while I was using right click for a lot of different things, so I had to take it off of that because it was just interfering. Yep, we got the course set, and all I have to do is hit engage for the course play, and that was gone. So, okay, I hope you enjoyed the episode.
Well, thank you so much for stopping by and watching one of my videos. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon so you know exactly when the next video comes out. I do offer a wide range of different kinds of videos, so check out the playlists. And you might find something else that you like other than this kind of video you watched today. Thank you so much. Comment down below what you thought, or just say hi. Have a great rest of your day.